The Joe Rogan Experience.
Yeah, that the stories are horrible of them leaving, you know, it's just fucking nightmare.
La historia de los judíos es dura, pero si tú miras la historia de los pueblos caucásicos también, cuando tú miras la historia de los chinos también, cuando ves la historia del éxodo de estos mismos, de nosotros los cubanos, de los 80, de la década de los Peter Pan.
What's Peter Pan?
Oh, también ese es otro éxodo también que tuvo Cuba, la gente de los Peter Pan.
Oh, I didn't know that one.
So what did he say?
No, we're talking about the different exoduses that you talk about, like the pain that all the races had, the Chinese and all that. But one of the big struggles is that Cuban one, that they leave, and like he left a son in Cuba. You know, his parents are in Cuba, you know. But then again, I mean, that's the story of the immigrant. Your grandfather left his brother in Cuba, in Sicily. You know, to make it better, to send checks to.
Yeah.
That's their plan. You know, you're gonna go to Cuba. You're gonna go there, send us checks until. So tu familia vive bien en Cuba.
Gracias a Dios.
His family lives well in Cuba because of his success. You know. What I'm saying?
So you can send Dios, you can send money back to Cuba.
Sí. Tú puedes mandar dinero.
Sí, sí, sí.
Si tú mandas 10 pesos, ¿cuánto le dan a tu? If you send $10,
ocho.
They give you 8.
Ocho.
Mm.
O sea, si mandas. Si manda 100,
if you send $100,
llegan 80.
They'll give them $80.
Mm. Yeah. So they take a little piece.
He met Fidel, by the way.
Really? You met Fidel?
¿Qué dice?
Que tú conociste a Fidel.
Sí, así como estoy contigo aquí.
The way you're sitting next to
him. Wow. Was that weird?
¿Cómo te sentiste? Era extraño.
No, you know. Yo siempre he tenido como figura a dos personas, como ejemplo, ¿no? Uno es Jesús, God, y el otro es mi papá.
He's had two heroes in his life, God and his father.
Pero cuando estoy enfrente de un ser humano, lo veo como un ser humano.
When he sees a human being, he sees a human being. He treats him like a human being.
Tú sabes, ahora, Dios le da talento a las personas.
God gives talent to people, like Matt Brown said. They're very talented.
Eso es lo que yo celebro, el talento de la persona.
He celebrates the talent of the human being, the human spirit.
Pero veo a todo ser humano como un ser humano.
But he sees everybody like a human being, you know.
So you just saw Fidel as a human being.
Tú viste a Fidel como un ser humano.
Como un ser humano que estaba ahora como presidente en Cuba, que era el presidente de mi país.
He was the president of his country, you know.
Now, being in America you've been here for a few years now. Are you completely settled in? You love it here. You're staying here. This is your spot now.
Ahora que estamos en Estados Unidos, tú te vas a quedar aquí. A ti te encanta esto aquí. Esto es todo tuyo. Ya.
No, no, yo no me voy a quedar. Ya yo me quedé.
No, not that he's staying. He's already fucking stayed. He's done. He's already here. He's here to stay.
I hear you, man.
No, I say thank you, God, for giving me the opportunity. My life is here in the United States, you know.
What's the difference? How does it feel different here?
¿Qué la diferencia aquí?
Just freedom?
Yeah.
Do whatever you want.
Yeah. You have a future.
You have a future.
You have a future. Your family have a future. You know what I'm saying? When you have an exodus in your family, when you have an exodus in your country, it's very hard. And it's very... you have emotion every day when you see the exodus in your country and your people, and you. Y tú tienes la posibilidad, tú llegaste.
You have the possibilities of getting here. You know, like you see this exodus, and you see, you know, and we didn't see it. We don't know what Grandpa Rogan did. I don't know what fucking Grandpa Rogan. I don't know why Grandpa Rogan left. You know what I'm saying? Like.
Right.
We all went through this at one point. Somebody in our family went through this.
Many people, Joe, lose the life intentando esto, llegar a esto.
A lot of people lose their life trying
to get here.
I say, y porque yo lo haya logrado, no olvido esto.
Because he completed that mission, he'll never forget that. You know?
De que tuve la posibilidad de no pasar ese éxodo de travesía de por el mar, no tuve el éxodo de la travesía de pasar países, fronteras y fronteras.
He was lucky that he didn't have to do that raft.
Right.
To go like the pitcher from the Yankees that had to go to the Dominican Republic, then they had to smuggle him out to
Colombia,
some other, like Colombia. Then the Yankees had to sign him, and that's the only way Steinbrenner showed up with an envelope, and then nobody knows nothing. He's happy that he went to Germany, and he had a plan, you know. And
yeah.
But you know what? Me siento con muchas personas hoy sus historias. Me siento a conversar con muchas personas, a escuchar sus historias.
He says he sits with a lot of people, listen to their stories.
Listen, this is 4 days before. Llego a un Walmart cerca de mi casa.
He went to a Walmart by his house.
Maybe the guy here está oyendo esto.
Maybe the guy is listening to this right now.
Fui a comprar, creo que comida a los perros y...
He went to buy food for his dogs.
Y a los conejos.
And for his rabbits.
Cuando salgo...
When he comes out.
Veo algo anormal.
He sees something not normal.
Entre un hombre y una mujer, una pareja.
A guy and a couple walked into Walmart.
Estaban discutiendo.
They were arguing.
Yo estoy poniendo las compras en la parte de atrás del auto.
He's putting the shit in his trunk.
Yo oigo que el acento es cubano.
He hears the Cuban accent.
Y tenía un problema.
They had some problem.
Okay. Pero yo me quedo para que no vaya a trascender.
So he stays so the problem doesn't escalate.
¿Entiende? Okay. Gracias a Dios no pasó nada. La muchacha, él se bajó del auto, cerró el carro, ella se fue. Y yo me monto en el auto y él se queda en su auto que estaba al lado del mío, like this. The car for the woman here, my car is here, and the car for the guy is here. Ella se fue, y él vino y se puso al frente del auto. Se sentó.
So the chick de-escalated, the chick left, and the guy sat next to him in the car next to him.
Yo me monto en mi auto.
Boom, he gets in his car.
Cierra la puerta.
Just closes the door.
Estuve de como dos o cinco, seis segundos esperando. Y lo veo a él like this.
He's all angry, the guy next to the fucking thing.
Yo bajo la persiana y
dice, lowers his window.
Y yo le digo, hey, bro, respira.
He tells the guy to breathe.
Y relaja.
And let it go.
No, ¿cómo fue que le dije? No vale la pena.
It doesn't, it's not worth the fucking anguish.
You know, he's coming to me. Él viene hacia mí. Y empecé a hacerme la historia de lo que estaba sucediendo.
And the guy got out of the car and started telling the story of what had happened.
Resumidas cuentas, me hizo una historia que llevaba un año aquí en los Estados Unidos.
He had been here for a year in the States.
Y me estaba contando lo que había pasado.
He wanted to tell him what happened to him.
En el cruce de, porque él venía creo que de Colombia.
He came from Colombia, the guy.
A llegar aquí a los Estados Unidos.
To come to the United States.
Y me estaba contando que hacía 15 días había visto a uno de sus amigos.
He saw 2 weeks earlier he had seen one of his friends.
Que había estado con él en el cruce de las fronteras.
That he had been in the journey with him from Cuba to Colombia and the whole thing.
Donde me estaba contando que ese amigo hacía unos días se había separado de la mujer de él.
So he was telling me that that same guy got separated from his wife.
You know why?
Why?
Porque no podía mirarle la cara a la esposa.
Because he couldn't look at his wife's face.
Él presenció como 12 hombres le hacían el sexo a su mujer en Colombia.
That she slept with 12 men in Colombia.
Y no pudo hacer nada.
And he couldn't do anything. So
nada.
That was part of the journey to get to the United States.
Oh, she had to do that in order to get over.
Yeah.
Damn.
This is Éxodo. Y eso es quizás una de las mínimas cosas.
And that's one of like the minimal stories, you know.
Porque los, no sé si tú sabes, en Cuba se salen por digamos, hoy te toca, somos familia, tú te vas hoy y a la semana que viene me voy yo. Like this. ¿Entiendes?
In Cuba, 1 week you leave, like me and you and brothers, you take off 1 week, and then my plan is to take off a week behind you.
Pero no tienen más comunicación después que salen.
But we don't have no communication after you leave.
Porque tienen que cruzar toda la selva.
Because you have to go through Colombia, the jungle. Colombia,
Ecuador.
Ecuador. You know?
Y se han encontrado hermanos cuando han cruzado la frontera en la selva. Es horrible. Pertenencias y el cadáver de su familia que hace unas semanas había salido antes.
That the brothers have found on the journey through the jungles of Colombia, they found their brothers' carcasses, like eaten, like, you know, by a lion or whatever on
their corpses.
Journey. Yeah, their corpses.
Yeah.
Y tienen que hacer esto, mirar, llorar y seguir adelante.
And you have to look, cry,
para llegar aquí a los Estados Unidos.
Keep going to get to the United States.
Jesus Christ.
Es duro el éxodo. Por eso yo todos los días say, God, thank you for you give me the opportunity. Very easy. It's not easy, but it's very easy when you look alrededor tuyo la vida de los demás.